Heaven's Day!
Huh?
No!
Out of the shine, I wasn't paying attention. Today we finished Marvel's new Netflix series, the culmination of their Netflix TV cinematic universe, The Defenders. Connor, what is the plot of The Defenders?
The Defenders takes place in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. This is Netflix division where, you know, the Marvel Cinematic Universe should happen, but it isn't important at all. And basically, it starts off with Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, and Iron Fist, kind of on what happened previously in their shows. Jessica Jones is a PI who's investigating some shit that leads up to the Hand. Luke Cage gets out of prison and is investigating a bunch of young black dudes getting harassed by the police, which somehow leads him to the Hand, of course. Iron Fist comes back from Kowloon being destroyed and is finding out about the Hand, and Daredevil has been related to the Hand, so he gets sucked into it. And at first, our four heroes are kind of reluctant to join this fight until Stick kind of comes out. Stick from the Daredevil series comes and is like, alright, motherfuckers, we gotta do this shit. So, you know, for the first few episodes, not, you know, it's kind of like everyone's either kind of dancing around the Hand or reluctant to join the fight against the Hand, but eventually Sigourney Weaver's character and the other four main players in the Hand come together and kind of force them into getting into this fight. And the Hand's main goal is to get immortality so they can continue kind of ruling this crime family they've been made over the last several hundred years. And Elektra is revived back from the dead and becomes the leader of the Hand eventually, and it all accumulates to the team coming together and fighting the Hand as a whole. So, Aidan, what did you think of Defenders?
So, it's pretty much hot garbage. It's really not even fair to call it one show, because it's basically five different shows. Four, but yeah, now it's five shows, because it all comes together into one crappy show in the middle. You got Jessica Jones, who has far and away the best thing going on, which is she's the only one who has an actual thing to do or a plot.
Until Daredevil gets a plot for the last two episodes.
She's investigating some guy who goes missing or dies in her office. She's looking for some guy, and so she has a thing to do, which is a lot more than anyone else has. Daredevil spends most of the time doing nothing, and then Elektra comes back, and then he loves her. But then,
yeah. I mean, why?
She probably
and then
she has Daredevil that dies.
But Iron Fist does.
He's like a dabber, dude. He's the
fucking punches some people around in the stars, and then
from the Avengers movie.
Later on, he gets kidnapped, and he spends most of the show just,
you know, he's the MacGuffin.
He's the MacGuffin, really. He's the Infinity Stone. And then Luke Cage does literally nothing.
Luke Cage seems
and then all this
fucking shit.
All the stories come together to Jessica Jones and Daredevil. Daredevil cries a lot about Elektra, and Jessica Jones does leader things, and Luke Cage stands kind of in the background because they couldn't figure out what to do with him, and Danny Rand is locked in basement somewhere. And so the show is pretty much boring garbage through and through. There's a lot of stuff to talk about. The plot's a mess. Especially in the early episodes, where the plot is we have to kill two episodes until these guys get together, so just make them do
two episodes. It's like six.
Every time Luke Cage shows up on the screen, rap music starts playing, and it's really embarrassing and weird and
a little bit racist.
It's weird. This movie, or this show, is shot in extreme amateur hour. Like, they got some cinematography and then shoot the whole thing.
Like, let's shoot it through the blinds because we can't see the scene. And he's like, what?
Every single shot in this thing is just, it's garbage.
The shots.
There's the part where they're talking in the jail at the start where there's like fake light lighting half the scene and like natural light lighting the other half. And they keep shooting it through like this window that has like the protective wiring in it. So like it's got this horrible two tones of lighting covered up with wires, and then at the, in the, one of the later episodes, the last episode, Foggy and Pepper Potts are talking, and they shoot it from like 8 billion different angles. Like sometimes it's like an extreme close up of Pepper Potts, and she's like, "Wow!"
Not Pepper Potts, it's Karen, but anyways, yeah.
Karen Potts.
Karen
Potts. And then they shoot it through the blinds, and you can't see anything, and then they shoot it like at this awkward angle where it's looking through glass, which distorts the terrible lighting.
Not to mention
on Foggy's fat rolls, and so you can like see the sweat beads on his face, and he's like talking, and it's like through a window, and you can still see like the protective wire. Like the show's a goddamn hot mess. It seems like it was shot in 20 days on nothing.
I thought we were talking about Defenders.
But the show, it suffers from a real lack of direction. It feels like they made all these shows and they said, okay, this is going to be the Defenders. And they're like, fuck, maybe we should have thought this out better. So they bring back all the villains, and then all the villains die. And it's pretty much just a boring slog all around. And appreciation for Jessica Jones, because everyone else in the show is so aimless and terrible that you're almost like, you know, she has something to do, so you're like, this is the best character in the show. And she's not good. She's like the alcohol award. She's like, I drink the alcohol and I'm grumpy, but I have a job to do, and everyone else is like, you know, let's have sex with the nurse. Pretty much just the other three gangbang the nurse for 10 episodes while Jessica Jones does things. And then the show ends. So, Connor, what did you think of Crap?
Crap.
Sweet!
Oh, we both did different memes at the same time. I said trippy, you said
sweet! It was 8 episodes. Very bad amount of episodes to pick. Here's how you should have done. Either do it in like 15 episodes or make it a 2-hour, you know, Netflix original movie. I was going to say like TV movie style. Make it a low budget Marvel movie. What they could have done is reinvested this entire budget and put it in 2 hours and actually made it like a solid movie. But instead, 2 episodes danced around being important. The problem is like, okay, you're following 4 protagonists. Instead of doing that for like the first 3 episodes where all the stories are shot like the goddamn Phantom Menace, for basically the first 4 hours of the show was the Phantom Menace, where it's like, okay, what's going on? And then none of the time frame makes sense. The thing's shot like a fucking student film. Well, if you made this a 2-hour movie, you could have just fucking made them come together in the first 15 minutes and then made them fight the hand. Boom. There was so much worthless crap they could have cut out, Or they could have went more in depth with everything if they made it like a 15 episode series, and then they could have said episode 1 is the Daredevil episode, episode 2 is the Jessica Jones episode, episode 3 is the Luke Cage episode, episode 4 is the Iron Fist episode, and then episode 5, Stick brings them all together. There you go. Actually, that's what they could have done with this show than the last two episodes.
You don't even need
15 episodes. You could have just made it 8 episodes and done it that way, where the first 4 episodes were each like an individual episode for everyone, where you catch up to their character, their thing happens, they lead to the hands, and then episode 5, 15 minutes in, they all meet up, they fight the hands, say, let's make a team, and then there's 3 or 4 episodes where they fight. But instead, it's like 3 episodes where you're awkwardly juggling all of the stories, the 4th episode where they come together, the 5th episode where they say, no, we're not really friends, the 6th episode where everything important happens, the 7th episode where nothing happens, and the 8th episode where everything else important happens that didn't happen in episode 6. The problem is you have 2 important episodes. You know what 2 important episodes means? 2 hours of important content. You know what that means? 6 hours could have been cut. You know what that means? They could have just made it into a feature film. So it's like, it makes no sense. So you either should have framed this better so it worked as a series, or just made this a movie. This could have been a movie. I bet, like, you know, maybe if a fan edited it, we could have had a 2-hour solid movie, fan edit. And, or, you know, maybe the footage isn't really there because it is shot like a TV show, but you could probably make a pretty solid edit or something. But instead, they dropped the ball on every level. Like Aidan said, the cinematography and the shot composition is some of the worst shot composition I've ever seen. I believe they brought a new showrunner in for this, which what they should have done is just taken the guy from Daredevil, or, you know, probably not Luke Cage, but whatever, and just had him do the show. Like, the guy who did the Daredevil show has done the best job so far, far and away, and he did 2 fantastic shows that were super binge-worthy, super great, super addicting. This show was like a chore to watch the middle episodes, and the first 4 episodes were like a chore. 6 and 8 were the only 2 episodes I really enjoyed. There were a couple of them that were okay in there, like episode 4 where they're fighting the hand and shit, but like episode 1 through 3, I kind of halfway just wanted to quit, and I'm like, well, if it wasn't for the review, I probably would have.
Yeah.
The other big problem
so fucking contrived too. It really detracts from the story. Like, all you had to do, Jessica Jones says, I need a lawyer. Okay, she needs Matt Murdock.
That's not even what they had to do.
She says, then Luke Cage is like, I need help. And she's like, I know a guy. And then, I don't know.
See, that's even overly cheesy.
That's overly cheesy, but that's here's about what happens. As cheesy as they all happen to break into the
here's
same
what happens.
Business room. And,
yeah. Right? That's
Wu-Tang Clan plays,
not Wu-Tang Clan, oh, no, Run the Jewels, the even more common, every movie ever. Here's what happens. Iron Fist comes back. He wants revenge because of Kao Long. He fights. He gets his ass kicked. The nurse is healing him and says, you need a team assembled. This is how you do it in a 2-hour movie for him, right? The nurse says, you need a team assembled. Brings Luke Cage and Daredevil in on it. Daredevil has it and Jessica Jones. Or, you know, somehow Jessica Jones gets into it, too. I didn't watch her show, so I don't really know her relationship with everyone else, so it's kind of hard to write that character, but, you know, somehow they all come together because of the nurse, because the nurse is the Sam Jackson of this show, and then Daredevil's all like, I don't want to do this, so is Jessica Jones. Halfway through the show, Jessica Jones eventually feels like she needs to be in on it. Elektra comes out, Daredevil says, fine, I'll be in on it, reluctantly, but he decides to do it. You know, they all team up, they fight the hands, they win, there you go. But instead, this show had to do all this contrived bullshit. And you know, this show would be so much better if they just said, what was I going to say? I don't remember. Honestly, though, it was just a mess. It was shot like shit. Whole thing was edited weird. It honestly should have been longer to establish everything better, or shorter, or just better put together, but unfortunately they just dropped the ball. And the thing is, look, you compare this. This is supposed to be the Avengers of the TV series. Avengers was cool because because it had no story, but it was a cool alien fight thing where you brought the characters together, and it made a ton of money in that respect. But the thing is, when you try to make a TV show of the Avengers, it's weird and awkward because all of the shows were so much different. I mean, Jessica Jones is a PI show. I haven't really watched the whole thing, but that's pretty obvious. Iron Fist was a kung fu show. Daredevil was more of a straight superhero show, and fucking Luke Cage was Black Lives Matter. Let's fucking Boys in the Hood too. That's racist and not completely accurate, but we'll say that. And so it was four different shows, and you combine them, and it's really awkward. You know, it just feels like honestly what Netflix should have done is said, here's a 2.5 hour long movie, or a 2-part series, or a 3-part series. But it's too long, too drawn out, so much useless shit that could have been cut out. And honestly, I bet you if I had if I had a pen and pencil and I watched the show 5 times and wrote it down, I bet you I could make a pretty solid 2.5 hour fan edit of this. That was just like the Defenders if it was done how it should have been done as a 2-hour movie. Instead of like a 50 minute fight scene like the last episode was. Or all that other crap. I don't know. So wait, would you recommend Defenders?
No, it's not worth the time. If you're looking for some modern superhero action, both seasons of Daredevil good. Luke Cage is good. Iron Fist is decent. It's not worth the time. So you'd have to have seen all the other shows and still want more and have nothing else to do. Even wanna
start. I watched this. All the show. I wanted more, and I wanted more to do, and I still thought the show was fucking garbage.
Yeah, it's a really God, what are you doing with those shoes?
Sleepy bed.
Anyway, I wouldn't suggest this show. I mean, I'm sure at some point there's probably going to be a fan edit made. Part of me wants to make a fan edit, but I don't want to invest the time into it. Because I feel like the bones were there. If this was a movie, a TV movie, I would suggest it. But the biggest problem with this show, overall, I mean, I said a lot of problems, but the biggest problem is there's a good 4 hours of content that could have been cut out of this show. But as it stands, I would watch episode 1, 4, 6, and 8. And probably pretty much understand what's going on. Yeah, you're gonna miss some exposition that if I was to make a fan edit, I'd put in there. But if you watch 1, 4, 6, and 8, you probably got a pretty good idea. You're watching the good episodes. You miss little to nothing. And yeah, so I wish I could suggest this show because I thought Daredevil, Iron Fist, and Luke Cage were all good shows, but unfortunately, it is what it is. So, since Aiden's about to fall asleep, I think that's all for it. Says it all, folks. Who's your favorite wrestler?
John Cena. I'm just kidding. Dwayne The Rock Johnson.